That was probably the biggest anticipatory Ravens press conference of the entire season. Because after the game, the way that it went yesterday, and when Lamar went down, we were all just like, oh boy. And we had saw some Twitter doctors say, oh yeah, it's a ankle sprain, and by the size of the boot, then it's a low ankle sprain, so that's much better than a high ankle sprain, because with a high ankle sprain, he'd be out for longer. But still, I just wanted something official, straight from the team, straight from Harbaugh. I just wanted something official, because that's, ooh. So Harbaugh did let us know today in the presser that Lamar Jackson has an ankle sprain, for sure. He did say it's not a high ankle sprain, so that was good news. But when Harbaugh was speaking today, man, he just, I don't know if y'all watched it, but he just seemed like so down. He seemed like he was so sad, so just out of it. Like, not the normal after a loss Harbaugh. You know, after a loss Harbaugh, he'll be a little snippy and whatnot. He'll be a little testy and whatnot, but he wasn't like that today. He just seemed very, very down, like extra down. So who knows? But anyway, he did say that he plans for Lamar to be out there on Sunday. But he said if Lamar can't go, then of course it's Huntley time. Now, let me stop you right there, coach. If he got an ankle sprain, rest him. Let him at least. And I don't think they really plan on Lamar really being out there. I think Harbaugh's just saying that because, you know, Harbaugh, he ain't going to be. All right, well, no, Tyler Huntley's the starter. Obviously, unless it's just some season-ending injury and it's clear-cut that Lamar won't be out. But I think he just wants to do that thing where he does a lot of the way, oh, all right, I want Green Bay Packers to have to prepare for Lamar, but they got to prepare for Tyler Huntley too. I don't want them just focusing on one of our guys. I want to put it out there like, all right, I want them preparing for both of them. So whoever ends up being out there, they can be halfway shocked. But I do not think that Lamar Huntley, I was about to say Lamar Huntley. I do not think that Lamar Jackson is going to play this Sunday. And if he's not 100%, I just really hope Ravens don't rush him. That would be the worst thing that they could possibly do, is rush him back. Don't do it, please. Please. I'm begging you, don't do it. I go out there and play quarterback for a little bit too now. But seriously, they do not need to rush Lamar Jackson back, because it can have long-term bad effects. So they don't need to do it. Anyway, back to the presser. He said that Sammy Watkins, his knee was bothering him a little bit. That's why he wasn't out there late in the game. Now, initially, I just thought it was that the Ravens were like, all right, Rashad Bateman and Tyler Huntley, they got the connection. They work with each other and practice more. And all right, it's his time. But injuries can dictate that a lot. Injuries can change. They can make a changing of the guards a lot. And I think that with Sammy, with whatever knee injury it was, and Rashad Bateman doing what he did, especially in yesterday's game, he got to stay out there. He got to stay out there. But we'll talk about that more in depth later on. Somebody asked if Lamar Jackson was on track to practice on Wednesday. And Harbaugh said that is an unanswerable question. Unanswerable. But okay, cool. He said that Calais Campbell, he's day-to-day with a soft tissue injury. And Harbaugh also talked about how he thought the secondary, they played pretty well overall. And I agree. Overall. They did have some little miscues here and there, some little hiccups here and there. But again, you ain't got no Marlon Humphrey. I still ain't had Marcus Peters. Ain't had Jimmy Smith. Ain't have Deshaun. Like, you're missing a lot of guys. But you're not only missing a lot of guys, you're missing a lot of veterans, especially on the outside. So stuff was bound to happen. But again, I thought they gave up 17 points. Like, a Ravens offense should, and again, minus the Lamar injury, of course. But if a Ravens defense holds a team to 17 points, Ravens offense, they should be able to take care of that. Now, 2020 Ravens offense, I don't know about all that, but normal Ravens offense, they should be able to take care of that. He was asked, see, this one was like, anyway. He was asked about Nick Boyle, with him not playing over the past couple of weeks. And he asked if there was some kind of like setback or anything like that, because we know first Nick Boyle, he was back, and then they were like, oh no, he got to clean up. He got to have a little cleanup with his knee, so he got to have another surgery. He had that surgery, then he was out for a while, then he came back, he played a game, and then we ain't really seen him since, and he been out. And Harbaugh said that it's part of recovery. And I was thinking, excuse me? It's part of recovery? So if that's part of recovery, why has he been out there in the first place? If he's still recovering, this is what I'm talking about. You can't rush guys back. If they're ready, they're ready. Great, let's go. But if they're not ready, you can't rush them back, because it's only going to hurt you, your team, the player, long term. We could have used Nick Boyle over these past couple of weeks. And even if I forgot what game it was that he did play in, he could have sat out then. He could have sat out for a couple more weeks if he wasn't ready yet. And then he could have been playing recently. And he could have been helping out. But if he's not ready, you cannot rush them. But this is why I'm very scared for what they're going to do with Lamar Jackson. Because it seems as if they did it with Nick Boyle. They did it with Ronnie Stanley. And the rushing them back. You can't do that, man. You can't do it. It's not a good look. And it's not a good procedure. Do not rush Lamar Jackson back. If he ain't 100, let him sit. Let him rest. Let him relax. Let him heal properly. We know what Lamar Jackson is. We know who he is. We know what he can do. We know what he's capable of. We know what he's done. We know all of that stuff. It's not going anywhere. Don't rush him back. Don't rush him back. Oh, Ravens, please don't rush him back. But he also said the Ravens are signing Tony Jefferson to the practice squad. So we'll talk about that more in detail a little bit later. But Lamar Jackson, again, this is overall good news. This is good that it's not a high ankle sprain. Low ankle sprain, though, he could be out for a little bit, though. But again, I don't expect him to play at all in this Packers game. I do not expect him to play at all. I expect him to call up Chris Sylvester, who they signed from Cardinals, or who got cut from Cardinals, but that was the last team he was on. I expect him to call him up and for him to be the backup quarterback on Sunday for Tyler Huntley, because I don't see Lamar playing at all. But hey, we'll see. Practice will let us know on Wednesday, because Wednesday is when all the boys come back to practice, and we'll see how things turn out. Team, keep it clean. I love y'all so much. I appreciate y'all a lot. And like I expect Lamar Jackson to be this Sunday, I'm out.